The fact that you are not here with us doesn't mean that you are not celebrating. And this is a beautiful challenge for all of us to grow in faith and to grow in the desire of our hearts to receive Jesus. Lord, show us the path of life we sing in the psalm today. The two disciples of Jesus, they were walking away for Jerusalem. Jesus went up to Jerusalem. The disciples were run away from Jerusalem. And if we put attention to the conversation between these two disciples, I think it's a conversation that sometimes can reflect where we are talking about our own situation today, where we are living today. Reflect confusion. They were pessimistic. They were sad, confused, lost. And that is where they were running away, walking away from the path that Jesus showed them to walk through Jerusalem, no way from there. And in our situation today, maybe we have the same kind of feelings, confusions, because of where we are living, our own experience today. And sometimes we can engage in this kind of conversation than it stay to give us hope to each other. We become depressed because we don't help to see hope. We only looking for the bad signs, not for the wonders. And then that, in the middle of that conversation, Jesus appeared to them and question them. Look at how beautiful it is how Jesus approached to these two. What are you talking about? Question them. And it's the same thing that in our daily lives, when we are in that kind of position, someone come and say, what is going on? What happened with you? And it's Jesus who is through that people, through that person, speaking to us. And for me, when I see this gospel, how it is divided in two parts, the gospel, when Jesus approached them, questioned them, and after that, in their own reality, in the way that they were living their lives, they start to talk about the scriptures to help them to understand their situation through the scriptures. And the second part is what? The breaking of the bread. It's the same thing as the Eucharist. For me, it's the first Eucharist celebrated after the resurrection. The same two parts that we have here. The first part is the liturgy of the world. We listen to the Lord, we reflect in the words of the Lord, and how we can apply that to our daily lives. The second part is the breaking of the bread. It's what Jesus did with the disciples. And that's what we do in the second part of the Eucharist, the breaking of the bread. And that is when they recognize Jesus. And how, look at how things change after that. Instead to become pessimistic, depressed, lost, they change immediately and they see life with another, in another way, with hope. And they went up to Jerusalem to the way that Jesus showed them to go and start to share with the other ones the good news. The good news. And that is the invitation of Jesus to us when we listen to the Word of God. How He is invite us to see life. how it can help us in times that are difficult to see that is hope in Him, how He can reveal Himself to us, and how we, unfortunately for most of you, the majority of you, we cannot take the bread, Jesus Himself, but after receiving Him and being transformed, we can start to bring in our conversation hope. Hope in Jesus. Hope that something good is coming, and we need to prepare ourselves to welcome that. Yes, it's difficult, but with Jesus, nothing is impossible. Jesus celebrated this Eucharist in the very first way with His disciples. And we're still celebrating the Eucharist. And in every Eucharist, we need to say to the Lord, Lord, help us to show us the path of life. Not my running away from You, but the way that You have prepared for us to live our lives. And finding them hope. I think I would like to challenge all of us to try to find a way to talk about something good. To try to find something nice that we can share in our families, in our friends, with a phone call. Something good always is there. But we need to bring, and we need to be today, in these special circumstances that we are living, we need to be messengers of hope, of the good news of Jesus Christ. But because with that, life will have another meaning. Growing up in faith, trusting in God, and finding Him in our daily lives, in that itself is a way to say thank you. We need to challenge ourselves. And doing that, find something good and let ourselves in prayer to find the voice of Jesus. Read the scriptures, not as a miracle book, as the Word of God who challenged us, as a rich source of life. Meditate there and see what the Lord is telling you and how the Lord is giving us hope now. And when things will change, we will have the full celebration of the Eucharist, all of us coming and receiving Jesus Himself in the second part, that is the breaking of the bread. Meanwhile, we are together, missing each other, but missing is great, because we say, I miss that person. Why? Look at that, how beautiful is that? Because I love that person. If we discover that is love there, how wonderful is that? And how thankful we need to be to the Lord for this beautiful gift, that in the middle of all of this, I can see that what I miss is what I love. Lord, show us the path of life.